Would you like to know the proper way to record depositing income when you keep home financial records? Well, then keep watching this video, QuickBooks Online for Home Finance, Depositing Income. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. It is extremely simple to record depositing income when you are using QuickBooks Online for your home finance records. First, simply open the register of the account you are depositing to. Then, record all relevant information, like what the reason is, whom you received it from, how much money, and so on. Then, just check the results in the trial balance. For example, let's imagine on January 7th of 2021, we received $1,000 from Molly's Saloon for bartending income earned, and we deposited check number 8472 into M&T Bank. Now, what will be the results? Well, right now the trial balance is blank, but after recording this first deposit of $1,000 into M&T Bank, M&T Bank will show up in the trial balance for the first time as $1,000. And because this was earned bartending income earned will also show up in the trial balance as $1,000. Let's take a look at how to record it. You can open the account register two different ways. You could click Accounting, Chart of Accounts, or you could click the cog wheel and go over to the Your Company column and click Chart of Accounts. Both would open the Chart of Accounts window. Simply scroll to the row of the account that you're depositing the money into, and in this case it's M&T Bank, and we click View Register. Now, we want to make sure that this is not set on expense. Make sure that the type of transaction when you click the pull down is deposit. The date will be January 7th of 2021. Now, even though Molly is not a payee, she's a customer, but she's still the person in the transaction. So we'll put this person, and the reason we got this money was bartending income. Now, it's hard to scroll through many, many accounts. It's easier to simply type in the first letter of the account you're looking for, and it will filter it by that first letter. And you can see here it is, bartending income. Go ahead and click. Now, you must make sure to put the number in the correct column, or you will have a problem later. This field is required because you chose deposit. So click where it says deposit and push tab, type in the money amount of 1,000. Pushing tab saves the field but keeps the window open. Now you might have to scroll to the right a little to get the save button, but after we click save, remember we earned $1,000 of bartending income from Molly's Saloon. Click save. Now when we click reports, trial balance, the results are as exactly as what we expected. $1,000 is now the balance of M&T Bank, and we now earned $1,000 in bartending income. What about this example? Let's imagine on January 17th, we deposited $500 from the Beer and Go, but also for bartending income, and it was deposited to Chase Bank. And of course, you're supposed to type in a number in the number field as well. So what will be the result after I record that transaction? Well, Chase Bank will show up for the first time as $500, because now there's a balance. And we have earned $500 more of bartending income, so bartending income will become $1,500. So let's take a look at how to record that. We click Accounting, Chart of Accounts, and this time the account that the money is being deposited into is Chase Bank. So on the row of Chase Bank, we click View Register and make sure that deposit is selected. Now the date was January 17th of 2021. And it was for whom? Well, it was Molly's, it was the Beer and Go. And we earned, type the letter B, bartending income. And this is a deposit we are required to put into that field, and we have to put the money amount that we actually deposited on that day. By the way, the reference number would be like check number or deposit number, but don't worry about it, just leave it. And scroll to the right, and we click Save. Now, when we close, we click Reports, Trial Balance, the results are as exactly as what we expected. Chase Bank showed up for the first time as $500, and bartending income also increased to $500. Let's do one more. Let's imagine on January 21, we withdrew $200 from M&T Bank for cash on hand. Now, cash on hand, we said, was another account that you pay from. It's like a bank type of account. So in this case, you have a choice which register you would like to record this transaction into. You could enter it into the M&T register in the payment column, or you could enter it in the cash on hand register as a deposit. The results would be exactly the same. It does not matter. So let's enter it as a deposit in the cash on hand register, because that's the same thing as opening the M&T register and opening it as a, putting it as a payment. So what will be the result? Well, we're taking $200 from M&T Bank, so that will decrease to $800, and cash on hand will show up in the trial balance for the first time as $200. Since the topic of this video is deposits, let's open up the cash on hand register and record this as a deposit. We click Accounting, Chart of Accounts. Then in the row of cash on hand, we click View Register. Now, we're going to add a deposit, and the date that we're adding the deposit is January 21st of 2020. And the account is M&T Bank, M&T Bank, because that's the other account involved in the situation. You can just type the first letter. See, and then it will filter. And we will, here we go, M&T Bank. So we're taking the money from the M&T Bank and we are depositing it to cash on hand. So we have to make sure the payee you can leave blank, and then the deposit you put $200. And now when we click Save, because you scroll to the right, Save, you can click Reports, Trial Balance, and you can see that cash on hand shows up for the first time as $200 and M&T Bank went down to $800. If you want to see all the transactions that add up to a specific balance in the trial balance, all you have to do is move the mouse to that money amount, and that sum you can double click. When you double click a sum total in the trial balance, you will get a window that lists every transaction that was involved in that account. For example, the two bartending income transactions were January 7th, you had Molly's Saloon for $1,000. Then again on January 17th, you had the Beer and Go for $500, and that's why the balance of bartending income is $1,500 at this moment. Reports, trial balance. Let's find out why M&T Bank is $800. So we double click the total and you can see a list of every transaction that was recorded in that account. January 7th, we got money from Molly's Saloon and we deposited from bartending income and it made the balance $1,000. Then we'll scroll to the left to get the date. January 21 on the next line, we put money into cash on hand. We lowered the balance of M&T Bank, which is the account we're in now. We lowered it by $200, and that's the reason the balance in M&T Bank is $800.